Hi, this is Lou DeWitt of the Statler Brothers, and we're on the Ralph Emery Show.
The which show, Lou?
That is our Emery.
That's right, Lou. And our show is presented by the way, which group do you sing with?
That's with the Statler Brothers.
I see. This show
Fan
is,
group.
Huh?
Fan group.
This show is presented by Buckwheat's Breakfast Cereal and by Chimpo's Potato Chips. And here's Freddie Weller to open our show.
I'm a road master, baby. I spend my life on the road. I'm a traveling musician, carrying a pretty big load. I spend my days driving down the highway, but when the show is over, I do things my way. So look out, honey, 'cause the road master's on the road. I met a pretty woman down in Nashville, Tennessee. She said she'd blow a harp if I could do a number in C. When the evening was over, I knew her pretty well. I said I'd like to stay around and talk a spell. But tomorrow I'm in Macon and the roadmaster's got to go. One night at a roadhouse, I thought it was the end of the line. I had a pretty waitress, but a truck driver hollered, "She's mine." I said I'd meet him out in front if he wanted to fight. And then I snuck her out the back like a thief in the night. And got the four wheels turning, got the roadmaster on the road. I'm a fool for the highway, I've never thought of settling down. I like to play my music where there's lots of pretty women around. I never noticed any difference in a woman and a lady. I'll take anything from 18 to 80 when the full moon's shining and the roadmaster's on the road. Never noticed any difference in a woman and a lady. I'll take anything from 18 to 80 when the full moon's shining and the roadmaster's on the road. When the full moon's shining and the roadmaster's on the road.
That's Freddie Weller with our show opener, Road Master. Want to know a good way to get the family tumbling out of bed in the morning and ready for any chores? Then you do like the man says.
Bring on a downright hearty breakfast. Pour out a wholesome bowl of buckwheat. Spoon up a taste like no flakes had before. You get bold. Brawny buckwheat together with a light snap of maple. It's the taste you've been missing in high nutrition. Put some buckwheats upon your table.
You'll know what a good idea that is when you try high nutrition buckwheats. Imagine a breakfast cereal the taste of buckwheat and maple. That's gotta be the greatest combination of flavors ever. But flavor's only half the story. Buckwheats is one of America's favorite high nutrition cereals. Helps a family feel like a million bucks. So get them up and get them going with buckwheats.
Put some buckwheats upon your table. Yeah, put some buckwheats upon your table.
This is Harold, way over here in the corner, Ralph. We were talking about something.
Well, you really got a voice that rumbles.
Yes, really does. I'm real proud of it. I keep it polished and spit up. Spit and polished, I'm sorry. We were talking today, Ralph, something that's never happened on your show. Nobody's ever interviewed you.
That's true.
You always ask your questions.
That's right.
And we thought that it would be kind of, it'd be like a new idea to maybe to ask you some questions. A lot of people don't know things about you they'd like to know. Let me start off, okay?
Go ahead.
Where were you born? What's your favorite color? What's your hobby? And how many children do you have? This is a tight show.
25 words or less.
Well, we're about out of time, Ralph.
Okay. Right. Listen, it's been nice being with you, Ralph. And anybody that has any more questions, write in. And here's Ralph's home phone number. It's
How are you serious?
Very serious.
I was born in McEwen, Tennessee. They call it Little Ireland.
And that is that near Nashville?
60 miles west of Nashville. My favorite color is blue. My favorite color combination is blue and white. I am married and I have three children. Did you ask me that?
And what are your children's ages? Do you want to tell that?
Yes, I have a son who is, he'll be 20 in October, and I have another son who'll be 5 in October, and another son who'll be, no, the second son will be 5 in November, and the third son will be 3 in October.
And did you want to talk about your grandchildren?
I have a little grandbaby. I've been a grandfather since last September, and she is very pretty, very pretty.
I'm sure. My pride favorite. Of grandfather, I'm sure.
Oh, yes.
With all boys up to this point.
That's right. Any more questions?
You, how many? Can you remember, right off the top of your head, how many service stations, radio stations you've worked at?
Let's see. I've worked one in Baton Rouge, one in Paris, Tennessee is 2, Franklin, Tennessee is 3, and 4 in Nashville. Seven.
You've moved around a lot, apparently. Does it have anything to do with your character?
No. Credit is what
credit,
it has to do with.
I used to move a lot, but not a lot in a long time.
Well, at that point, you were improving upon yourself and your career.
Well, I couldn't go any further, so I stayed where I was. I'm going to play one of your records.
Please do that.
This is a Jack Clements song called Got Leaving on Her Mind. It's very short, and we could use a good short song at this part, at this point in the show.
The longer I know her, the more I can tell. My darling's not happy with me. The longer I know that I know her too well, the less love in her eyes I see. Cause she don't hold and kiss me like she did one time. I think my sweet baby's got me on her mind.
Our guest, the Statler Brothers, singing Got Leaving on Her Mind. Now I need Phil there to introduce the next song, if you will, Phil.
The next song is by Cal Smith, I Found Someone of My Own.
Now, that was pretty cool the way he thought,
Thank
I found
you.
Someone
Thank you.
Of my own. I really liked it.
I got up this morning, and while I was having my coffee, my woman came in and sat down by my side. With tears in her eyes, she said, I've a confession to make. And I said, woman, speak what's on your mind. She said, I found somebody new to take your place. I said, don't feel so all alone. I found someone of my own. When you left me all alone, oh, my new love would call and comfort me on the telephone. And I said, darling, if that's the way it's gotta be, oh, sweet woman, don't you worry about me. She said, I found somebody new to take your place. I said, don't feel so all alone, I found someone of my own. I got up from the table, I reached down and wiped the tears from her face. I put out my cigarette, turned and walked away. She said, I found somebody new to take your place. I said, don't feel so all alone, I found someone of my own. She said, I found somebody new to take your place. I said, don't feel so all alone.
Cal Smith, Cal with his first hit. He had a pretty good record years ago on Drinking Champagne. But this is the this is his biggie.
That was written by a rival disc jockey of yours.
It was written by Bill Mack.
Right.
Not a rival, but...
he said he was.
He's
no, really. He didn't say anything when we asked him about it. He's just sitting there. He's weird, boy.
Cal Smith singing, I Found Someone of My Own. You know, when you eat fried chicken, you kind of expect to get some grease on your fingers. Mm-hmm. And licking your fingers when you're finished is all part of the fun. But that's not so with potato chips. And that's part of the reason for the mention of Chippos. Have you tried Chippos yet? Well, when you do, you'll find them to have less oil on the surface than ordinary potato chips and better potato chip flavor. And although we can't promise you clean fingers, at least you'll know Chippos have less surface oil. You see, unlike ordinary potato chips, which are made from raw potato slices, Chippos are made from dried potato granules. This new Betty Crocker way takes the granules, shapes them into chips, and then flash fries them. And the result is Chippos, the new fashioned potato chips that have less oily taste and far better flavor. Make this your day to discover Chippos, the potato chip that's fashion for flavor. Now, would you take over at this point and bring on our next star?
Our next star is Jerry Reed. There's a song that he wrote. I believe Elvis Presley did this song.
Mm-hmm.
Guitar Man.
Mm-hmm.
And if there ever was a guitar man, it must be Jerry Reed.
Well, I quit my job down at the car wash, left my mama a goodbye note. By sundown, I left Kingston with my guitar up under my coat. I hitchhiked all the way down to Memphis, got a room at the YMCA. For the next 3 weeks, I went a-haunting them nightclubs looking for a place to play. Well, I thought my picking would set them on fire, but nobody wanted to hire a guitar man. Well, I nearly about starved to death down in Memphis. I run out of money and luck, so I bummed me a ride down to Macon, Georgia, on an overloaded poultry truck. I thumbed on down to Panama City, started checking out some of them all-night bars, hoping I could make myself a dollar making music on my guitar. Got the same old story, them all-night peers, there ain't no room around here for a guitar man. But don't need a guitar man, son. So I slept in hobo jungles, bombed a 1,000 miles of track, till I found myself in Mobile, Alabama, at a club they call Big Jack's. A little four-piece band was jamming, so I took my guitar and I set in. I showed them what a band would sound like with a swinging little guitar man. Show 'em, son. So if you ever take a trip down to the ocean, find yourself down around Mobile, or make it on out to the club called Jackson, you've got a little time to kill. Just follow that crowd of people, you'll wind up out on his dance floor, digging the finest little five-piece group up and down the Gulf of Mexico. And guess who's leading that five-piece band? Why wouldn't you know, it's that swinging little guitar man. Yeah, hey.
That's Jerry Reed, Jerry singing the Guitar Man. While we're at it now, any more questions before we wrap my portion of being interviewed up?
Yes, if you weren't here, Ralph, where would you like to be?
Where would I? Boy, that's a tough one. I'd probably rather be home watching Mannix or Hawaii 5-0.
Almost anybody would rather be home than where they're at, wouldn't
they? any other questions? That's it.
Is there anybody, Ralph, speaking of interviews, is there anybody that you have never interviewed you'd really like to get back into?
You know, I have a secret ambition. And I suppose there are those I would like to interview, like Jack Benny. Mm-hmm. But I have a secret ambition. I would like, on network television or radio, and you wouldn't even have to see me, I'd like to say, and now, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States. Just like to do that.
Well, you just fulfilled it.
Well, he's not here, though.
Oh, okay.
And have him come on and sing.
Well,
or me, come on and talk.
There's some talk he's going to be your guest next week. Have they told you about
it? No.
He may be.
Who's next on the show, Lou? Right quick.
This is Tammy Wynette's turn at the bat. She's singing Reach Out Your Hand.
Reach out your hand. And touch somebody. Together build a dream to call your own. Reach out your heart and hold somebody. You've got too much love to give to be alone. The world has never been so cold and lonely. The sky has never been a deeper blue. Just like you, there's someone just as lonely. And you know, God made them special just for you. Reach out your hand and touch somebody. Together build a dream to call your own. Got too much love to give to be alone. Reach out your hand.
Miss Tammy Wynette, Tammy, and the pretty song, Reach Out Your Hand. You know, it's funny. Some people have got the idea that anything that's good for them
can't possibly taste good, too. Well, those people are in for the pleasantest surprise since the discovery of the apple. That surprise is in Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. Buckwheat's not only has what it takes to help you feel fit, it's got a flavor combination like no breakfast cereal ever had before. Brawny buckwheat flavor with a snap of maple in crunchy golden brown flakes. It's good. Yet nutritious buckwheats helps you feel like $1 million, and that's a great feeling.
Feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive.
Got a feeling like.
Feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive. Buckwheats with a hearty taste. Buckwheat and maple taste, and you're feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive.
High nutrition and good taste, all in one great cereal, Buckwheats.
We're going to have Charlie McCoy bring out his harmonica at this point. I guess he's been on your records.
Oh, yeah.
Playing something.
Almost every one of them.
The most versatile musician in Nashville, I suppose. Charlie follows his recent hit of Today I Started Loving You Again with an old Hank Williams song. I'm sure you'll remember it. Charlie McCoy, Charlie with Hank Williams' old song, I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry.
This is Phil Balsley with the Statler Brothers, guesting on the Ralph Emery Show. Just want to remind you that you're listening to the Ralph Emery Show, and here's a real fine record by Bill Rice.
I gotta go when I feel the urge. I was born the moving kind. I may never pass this way again. I'm just following my mind. Be a friend and we'll talk a while. The only thing I've got is time. Lord, Lord, share a smile and a yesterday, and I'll have something to call mine. So you just shake my hand before I go, then I'll be satisfied to know to have a friend is not a waste of time. Memories of the friends I've known are all I have to call my own. I have
something to call mine. Life's a road that we all must walk, and you can't see around the bend. Here a while, oh, but then it's gone, like a whisper on the wind. Life is yours for a little while, so be happy while there's time. Lord, Lord, and while I'm here, if I make you smile, then I'll have something to call mine. So you just shake my hand before I go, then I'll be satisfied to know to have a friend is not a waste of time. Memories of the friends I've known are all I have to call my own, but I have something to call mine. You just shake my hand before I go, then I'll be satisfied to know to have a friend is not a waste of time.
Bill Rice writes great melodies, really does. Bill Rice singing a song he wrote called Something to Call Mine. And we're going to get some of that Statler harmony on again. You guys, you ever do comedy songs? See, I don't recall ever seeing your stage show, and I presume it's a little different than what you're putting on records. Is that correct?
Quite a bit different.
Yeah. We do probably about 50% comedy on the stage shows. And you have seen a stage. You worked with us one time in Springfield.
Illinois.
Long time ago,
yeah.
We do, all of our records, plus we do a lot of comedy.
Don, since I've got you on the microphone, this is Don Reed I'm talking to. You and Harold are brothers.
Right, I'm sorry.
And the other guys are just along for the ride, right?
Right.
Free ride, I might add. Free ride, I might add.
And at the outset of this show, I understand from all of you, you're married.
Right.
How many children collectively do you have?
A dozen?
How many do you have?
One.
How
four.
Many? Lou has four, that's five. Phil?
I've got three.
That's eight.
I have four. Yeah. Eight and four is 12.
That's right.
And, oh, that's all we're counting then.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, just those.
What were you going to add?
No, well, I've got some baby peepees too, but it's no use counting them because they're not mine.
Some what?
Baby peepees. Little chicks.
Little chickens.
You know.
We sent in the radio. Got them, you know.
Yeah.
Did you really?
Yeah. Sent to Clint, Texas.
Chick.
C-H-I-C-K.
We came with us on the road.
You do? You want to get into that?
No, really we don't.
You know, now you're bringing up a subject. The old Johnny Cash show had a reputation for taking
that.
Chickens into hotel rooms and turning them loose.
They, right. One night, they were telling the story. This was before we came with the show, but they had raised some chickens on the road, and they got on an airplane. They had five left out of 100 or whatever they'd bought. And they got on an airplane, and they said, you can't take no chickens on an airplane. And the great Johnny Cash told them, he said, these are purebred chickens, they're thoroughbreds, and I will not let them go anywhere without me. And they had them in a chicken coop, took them on the plane, turned them loose down the aisle. The plane got to where they were going, they got off and left the chickens on there.
I mean, they did allow John to take them with him.
Right, and that was the week after that was the only time airline food was any good.
You boys were about to sing a song called She Thinks I Still Care.
She thinks I still care. Just because I asked a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I rang her number by mistake today, she thinks I still care. Just because I haunt the same old places, where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I'm not the happy guy I used to be, she thinks I still care. And if she's happy thinking I still need her, then let that silly notion bring her cheer. Oh, how could she ever be so foolish? Tell me, where did she get such an idea? Just because I asked a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I saw her then when all to be said, she thinks I still care. How could she think I still care?
Our guest, the Statler Brothers, and a great old song. George Jones used to just sing the fire out of that. Dickie Lee wrote that song, didn't he? Right. Yeah. She Thinks I Still Care. And now for Chippo's, here's Bobby Budd.
If you're planning to have a party and make sure that it swings, get lots of Chippo's potato chips. That's the important thing. Chippo's potato chips, the tastiest chips that you ever did dip. They're solid tasting, good and crisp, the best flavored chips you ever did dip. Make sure the dip's on the table. I like cheese and onion too. Then pour out the Chippo's potato chips, and that's all you gotta do. Chippo's potato chips, the tastiest chips that you ever did dip. Less oily tasting, good and crisp, the best flavored chips you ever did dip.
Makes my mouth water just to think about those good chips made from dried potato granules and flash fried. Less oily tasting with better flavor. That's Chippo's potato chips. Harold, you guys get tired of being interviewed about Johnny Cash?
Yes, we really do. That's cutting you off short, Ralph, but we really do. Poor old John, we've talked about him more than we've talked about people we don't like.
I just... you know, not you don't meet many people that work with a show business phenomenon like Johnny Cash, and I wondered if you had noticed people as they approach John, if people become all unglued trying to say something to Johnny Cash, or if they act funny.
Well, yeah, they'll come up to tell him they enjoyed the show and wind up telling him about a crippled aunt they've got in Peoria, you know, and would he please sing a song for him. And they get, you know, things go to pieces on them. And they don't have any composure like Don right now. You hear that? His string just broke on him. You all right now? No, but I guess people have a tendency to be that way around a big star or whatever.
Yeah. Harold, have you guys... Has it ever been proposed that you wear black as well? Would that be a no-no in the Johnny Cash show?
It goes back to something that we have talked about before, about losing our identity, yeah, or whatever. Those are some of the things that's never been suggested to us. John has always let us do our thing. if we went out on the stage and John said do two numbers, you can get covered up pretty well like that. But we do like 30-minute show, so it gives us a chance to sell. And to answer your question about the black, no, we like wear any kind of clothes we want to.
Who picks the uniform of the day?
There again, it's just a collective thing. We leave home with a few outfits, and just whoever dresses first puts on whatever they want, and then everybody follows suit.
Follow suit. Did you get that?
That was a pun. It was not only a pun, it was a brilliant pun. We went swimming in a pun once.
Let me bring out 15-year-old Louis Roberts. Here's a song I bet you've sung at one time or another.
Many times.
Old Time Religion. This has been updated. I don't know whether you've heard this version, but to include Billy Graham.
Oh, yeah, sure have.
I want that old time religion. I need that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. It's good enough for me. Wasn't it good for Billy Graham? The great work of Billy Graham. Isn't it good for Billy Graham? Lord, it's good enough for me. I want that old-time religion. I need that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. Wasn't it good for Miss Jackson? So good for Mahalia Jackson. The late great Mahalia Jackson. Lord, it's good enough for me. I want that old-time religion. I need that old-time religion. I want that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. It's what we need for our country. All we need for our country. It's what we need for our country. Lord, it's good enough for me. I want that old-time religion. I need that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. Give me that old-time religion. I want that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. I want that old-time religion. I need that old-time religion. I want that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. I want that old-time religion. I need that old-time religion.
Louis Roberts, 15-year-old Louis Roberts singing old-time religion. Here's a fellow I don't often feature on this show, but I love this record. It's by Wayne Newton, he of the very high voice. Hey, you and Harold, you and Wayne Newton make a great duet.
Yeah, I would really like to get with Wayne Newton sometime. he keeps calling me, and I won't take his call. I can't talk to a guy that talks that high.
Here's Wayne with Daddy Don't You Walk So Fast.
Was dying, and it got so bad I knew I had to leave. But halfway down that highway, when I turned around, I saw my little daughter running after me, crying,
Daddy, don't you walk so
fast. how it broke my heart to tell my little daughter that her daddy had to run to catch a train. She had no way of knowing I was leaving home for good. I turned around and there she was again, as she said to me, "Daddy, don't you walk so fast. Turn back home right there and then, and try to start a new life with the mother of my child. I couldn't bear to hear those words again. She said, "Daddy, don't you walk so
That's Wayne Newton on the program. Wayne, and the song is really, I think, is it's one of those I call a grabber. It really makes you listen to it. "Daddy, Don't You Walk So Fast." You know, sooner or later, there comes a time when you got to think about staying in good shape. And when that time comes, a little help and encouragement goes a long way. Here's an example.
I'm helping Jim, that's my husband, keep himself fit. He does the exercise, and I give him buckwheats. That's Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. General Mills makes it. And they make it to help you feel like a million bucks. That's what they say, and I believe it. All those vitamins and minerals? Just the kind of nutrition my husband needs to help him get going in the morning. But you gotta be prepared for one thing. Buckwheats really go fast. Something about that buckwheat and maple flavor that Jim just can't get enough of makes it that much easier for me to help him.
Nothing like Buckwheats to help a wife, help a husband feel like a million bucks. Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. Why don't you go out and get some today?
I went back to one of the earlier Statler albums for Walking in the Sunshine. Do you think you've changed, I mean, in your sound?
Not basically. It's just that we were so cramped at Columbia that we couldn't sing. And then when we changed labels and went to Mercury, we had a chance to do, you know, some things.
What do you
we
mean
wanted
cramped?
Well, everything from New York to Nashville, there was one time that they forgot we were on a label.
Really?
They put out one of our songs, forgot our name, you know, things like that. It makes you feel a little unwanted.
Play the record, please.
Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Put a smile upon your face as if there's nothing wrong. Think about a good time had a long time ago. Think about, forget about your worries and your woe. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. La 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 la. A snowy pasture, a green and grassy field. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Put a smile upon your face as if there's nothing wrong. Think about a good time had a long time ago. Think about, forget about your worries and your woe. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. a snowy pasture, a green and grassy field, walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Put a smile upon your faces if there's nothing wrong. Think about a good time had a long time ago. Think about, forget about your worries and your woes. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song. Walking in the sunshine, sing a little sunshine song.
Our guest, the Statler Brothers, singing Walking in the Sunshine. Don Reed, why don't you sign this show off, would you please?
Yes, this is Don Reed, friend of Billy Forbes of the Statler Brothers, and you've been listening to the Ralph Emery Show.
Brought your way by Chippo's Potato Chips and by Buckwheat's Breakfast Cereal. Who's Billy Forbes?
I have no idea.
Hey, we'll see you tomorrow. We hope you'll be listening.
We'll be back.